How did I get away with combining metal and funk? What? Just a quick note, if you want the full breakdown of the riff you've just heard, here's the card of the video. Today we will go through the funk part and how the hell I managed to pull that off. We will go through what is in between those two parts and how I wrote the full funk part, including the drums, bass, rhythm guitar, and, as the fourth thing, lead guitar. Let's dive straight into it. Okay, I was just sitting in this couch right here, and I was just experimenting with some chords and putting them into a funk vibe, and then I thought, oh my god, it would be sick if it was in the song I'm just writing. Yeah, so that's how the idea actually came to my mind, and then I needed to record it straight away. And decided that, like, I really wanna make this a full part and it's gonna be hilarious. I was already thinking of the lead guitar and how all the stuff is gonna play together. And the first thing I had to do after the rhythm guitar were the drums. I was searching the internet for some, like, funk grooves and how, like, funk drumming actually works. And I found something interesting. And that's like playing with the open hi-hat.
Hey everyone, I'm Jared.
And like the snare pattern is not always like 2 and 4 or 1 and 3. It's always kind of changing. There's also some ghost notes happening. And the kick drum pattern also isn't the same from what I've found. And so from my 2-day experience, drums are probably a real key part of funk music. Then I did the bass. And with the bass, articulations are key. I've watched some video which I'll link in the description down below, and it opened my eyes, like, oh my god, there's just so much happening articulation wise, like sliding, hammering on in the bass also. I always thought that bassists are doing some, like, always fingering the notes or always picking them or whatever, but no, they're using so many articulations, and that makes the funk bass groovy and, well, funky. Okay, next up came the lead guitar, and oh my god, the first time I played the riff, the part in the middle, which I'm gonna cover in a minute, and the funk part, oh my god, I started laughing out loud as never before when writing a song. It was just so hilarious, and I think that the song really, really deserves a kind of moment like this. Because the idea of this is like, you've won, so here's your, like, anthem or, like, victory part, I guess. Yeah. I don't know, it's just hilarious. This part was the most fun to write. I've improvised it fully, and I did it for like 2 hours straight, and I've had so much fun writing this. But then, oh my god, I've waited for like a couple minutes, played again, and the best idea was just thrown in my head and in my fingers, and it came to the door, recorded beautifully, and that's what you're gonna hear right now. Okay, the part that makes these two work together is the thing in between. And the part is just chords which are modulating, like, there's two modulations. First up is to G minor and the second one is to G major. So, like, from A minor to G minor and then to G major. And that, like, made it go through some struggles to the victory, as I would call it. And if it were in the same key, the part wouldn't... It just... I don't know how to describe this, but if it were in the same key, the funk and the riff part, it just wouldn't glue together, in my opinion. I won't go over the chords in depth, because I would probably waste 90% of you people's time, but for the 10% of you, here are the chords on screen. I love it. Yeah, I like all of these three parts, and now let's hear them together. Again, if you want a full breakdown of the riff, you can check it out in the description down below. What do you think about this part? Tell me in the comment section. I would love to know what you think and if you've also laughed as I did when listening to this for the first time. If you've gotten all the way through to this, bear with me because I have a gift for you. Normally, I have all the tabs for my music on Patreon, but the tabs are gonna be on Dropbox in the description down below for a week from uploading this video. So go ahead and click it if you wanna get the tabs for free. But if you want the rest of the tabs or wanna support me, go ahead to patreon.com. And, well, you can support me. I'm thankful for every single one of you guys watching my videos, and you can watch another video over here. I'll see you then. Goodbye.